Hello, welcome back to PlayStation Access, where today I am joined by Nath.
Hello.
Hello, Nath. And hello. I'm going to tell you everything that I know about Ghost Recon Breakpoint.
I have 2 minutes. Let's go.
I'm suggesting it's not very much. Yes, I know. Actually, more than you might think, because I've played it. How do you feel about that?
Whoa!
How do you feel about that?
Quite confrontational. I guess it is a war game.
I've played it, and I spoke to Ubisoft a little bit about it. And okay. I'm going to kick straight off. I mean, if you followed the game at all, you will know, probably, that it stars John Bernthal this time.
Oh, I want him to be my friend.
I want him to be my friend, too. He was really cool. He was at the Ubisoft conference with a dog.
Right.
Which, you know, everybody likes. It's just a good way to... liked by people, a dog. But yeah, it's particularly exciting, not only because he's a really good actor, but he actually has just starred in DLC for Wildlands. Now, in the Wildlands DLC, he's your ally.
I like that. Like I said, I wanted to be my friend.
In Breakpoint, he is your enemy.
Oh, no, why? What's happened in between? Have they gone rogue? Have I gone rogue?
I think, actually... I think that a lot of Breakpoint is going to be uncovering that. So in the course of the mission that we undertook when I played Breakpoint, we had a flashback with John Bernthal. Well, not with him, with this character.
Yeah. And you were friends in the flashback?
Yeah, so in the flashback, we knew each other. We'd worked together on an operation of some kind. Yeah. And I think there might maybe more flashbacks, which is uncovering what has happened. He's now in charge of this kind of, I think, slightly mysterious group of operatives called Wolves.
Right.
And they are bad.
They're like dogs, aren't they?
Wolves?
Yeah.
So you said they were mysterious.
Sorry.
Right, okay. Fair enough. Yes, and it's worth noting, actually, that... This is kind of maybe a hard thing to put right, but this I just thought this cutscene was really good. It really benefited from having him. Do you know what I mean?
He's really, like, he's great, man.
He was starring alongside someone who was also great. I just really enjoyed, you know, sometimes, particularly at an event where you haven't been playing the game from the start.
You dropped in and you're not sure what's going on.
I don't really know what's going on.
Right.
I was not getting that at all. I was like, it was the two guys were in a sort of like a sniper's nest. They were clearly waiting for some guys to come out of this base of some kind, and they were talking about stuff. They were just having a nice interaction whilst waiting to kill some people.
Right.
And it was really, really compelling. I liked it a lot.
Cool.
So let's move on to what you are, or who you are. You are Nomad.
Okay.
And Nomad, so this time around, Wildlands was set in Bolivia. This time we're setting in a fictional island called, let me get this right, it's not Aurora, it's Aurora.
Oh.
I want to say Aurora every time, even though I can't say it, but it's Aurora.
Aurora.
And it's kind of it's an island, it's going to have lots of different environmental kind of, you know, it's going to have snowy peaks and sandy beaches.
They can do what they want, it's fictional.
They can do what they want, it's fictional. And so Nomad, for reasons unknown to me, crash lands on this island.
Right,
and
so they're not supposed to be there?
I don't believe so, no.
Okay.
Well, maybe they were just meant to land there, but they crashed down there.
Right, okay.
And they are trying to, at the start of the game, you're trying to meet up with your teammates, your team of operatives.
I see.
But there's a kind of mysterious force at work, which I think are the Wolves.
Is it Smoke Monster?
I think it's the Wolves.
Right.
Not real Wolves.
No,
men,
the ones like dogs.
Who call themselves Wolves.
Right.
But also there's these Wolves, they have very advanced technology.
Right.
There's a facility on the island which is, and this is like kind of like a global thing, you know, in this fictional world.
Yeah.
A group called Skell, I think, who make this advanced technology, and it's like drones and like AI robot things.
So it's all that Tom Clancy stuff.
So I like this because I think, you know, I think Wildlands went down a very realistic route. It was about, you know, kind of real world things like drug cartels and, you know, the weapons were all very what you would expect and the enemies were humans, you know. Whereas this time it was a slight sci-fi feel to it.
Okay.
And the advanced technology, I don't know, like for instance, one of the bosses, there was a boss that we fought, kind of, which was like a giant robotic tank.
Okay.
Which was massive and kind of growled, made it, you know, it felt
Metal Gear kind of.
There was a Metal Gear influence, I would say. So it's very different this time around. Furthermore, there's a big kind of focus on survival, I'd say, this time around. So your character will be gathering resources.
Sure.
for crafting, so you can craft I mean, in the demo I played, we were only able to craft syringes and bandages, but okay. they are useful.
They're good for surviving.
But I think you're going to be crafting other things as well, maybe ammunition and maybe buffs of some kind.
Yep.
You do that from your bivouac, which is not a word I ever want to spell.
Right, but, I actually know how to spell it, but...
Well, so do I, but I don't I just don't want to.
But why... I didn't expect you to say it. Why is it called a bivouac?
Bivouac. I guess it's a survival term, isn't it? It's like a little camp, maybe, that you put up quickly.
Right.
And so you could... I don't know exactly the mechanic of this.
Where that word comes from?
Because our demo was kind of led by one of the development team, and
sure.
he was always... putting up the bivouac,
right.
but I think it's in set places. I don't think you can just pop your bivouac out anywhere you fancy. You have to do it in a very controlled zone, so which makes sense. So from here you can craft, and you know, we were only able to craft syringes and bandages, but I think you were going to be able to craft other things as well.
Yep.
Well, obviously you'll be able to craft other things as well.
They're survival, though.
They are. You can also apply buffs, and for example, it's quite funny because it's based on real world things, like
right.
to have, I think it was a stamina boost. I had a half an hour stamina boost of like 20%, and to do that I just had to hydrate, and you
right.
get a little cutscene of just having a drink from
your
canteen.
You love water as well. You've got like a giant water bottle in the office.
I do, yeah, I do. So and that's what I chose to do. I hydrated.
Right,
but you can also you can eat, which I think reduces like impact damage, and it's things like that.
That has never been the case for me in real life.
You could also change your class.
Okay.
So
very difficult these
there
days.
There are three classes you could choose between. But I just stuck with the assault class,
right.
because
is that kind of like
I like the guns.
Middle gunman.
It's the sort of all rounder one, isn't it? Yeah.
And there's like, is it like tank and then more kind of a high damage stealth?
Yeah. So they had Panther, who was I think very stealthy,
right.
kind of a character.
Sure, sure.
And there was like a sniper class as well. So yeah, and more than that, talking about surviving, you're going to get shot probably, or
yeah,
maybe exploded.
Yeah.
And this time around, they've introduced injuries. So
oh,
you
no.
have a health bar. It's kind of sectioned. I think there were five sections, as you might expect. You know, once you go down into the section
segment,
below,
right, you can't get back up.
Exactly. On top of that, though, they've added injury. So if you're getting taking damage, you might just
no.
deplete your health bar. You
right.
might get injured. And injuries you can't fix with syringes, and kind of there isn't a quick fix. You
right,
have to
right.
take time to apply a bandage, which will then... so it's like a cap on your health then,
yeah,
you know,
you're
once
saying.
You're injured. But on top of that, it also has an effect. So I think I got shot in the leg, and then
hurt.
I was like limping and slow.
Oh,
and
man.
It was very like, it was really cool and contextual. Like
right.
he was applied
to a
when
certain
I,
point, it's like, oh, wow, that's really, but I hope, I mean, I'm sure that this is part of what they're doing is because that stuff can also be like, now I can only move at like half the speed that I want to. And this, you know, I mean, I no longer feel like a powerful, cool army man. I feel like me if I'd been shot in the leg.
Yeah, but I mean, well, I guess the point being that you're going to be, you know, working to, there's a lot of teamwork involved.
Okay.
You're going to be working. And also you're going to need to, I think in general, with this Ghost Recon, this time around, they want you to think a bit more. There's going to be a bit more planning. I think
oh,
the kind of encounters are going to be more a bit more elaborate than before. It's not quite so straightforward,
okay.
Which I think is really exciting, and
yeah,
especially
yeah.
because I was lucky to play it with four other players, or
yep.
three other players, I should say. There were four players,
bit
including
of
me.
Bit of maths.
Good maths. And, you know, there's no like cooler thing than infiltrating a base, coordinating a sync shot and stuff, and doing
yes.
that. We did that a whole bunch and just felt very, very cool. And when somebody goes down or needs cover or, you know, then you've got your team around you. If you're playing in single player, it's worth pointing out that this time around you won't have AI companions.
Oh.
You'll have a drone with you which can perform certain tasks that, you know, you couldn't, that you
I
would
see
usually
see.
Use humans for.
Yeah, sure.
So yeah, I think that the story is going to be a big part of this game as well.
Nice.
And lastly, on the survival kind of thing, and again, maybe a slight Metal Gear kind of
nod.
Influence
mm.
is camo is a bit more of a thing.
Cool.
Not that you have to change your camo, but
right.
rather it's when you've gone prone, you can hold triangle,
yeah.
I think, to kind of bed in to
okay.
where you are.
And
it's like, I think it's a bit of a kind of a last resort if you find yourself in the open and suddenly there are enemies.
It's good,
up.
Isn't it? Having played a bit of Metal Gear, we can reference it in videos.
I know. Yeah, well, we're basically experts now.
Maybe all those people who were like, how are you on this channel without having played Metal Gear? Maybe they were right.
No. It's nice, isn't it? You've got to see the other side.
Yeah.
So that's basically, I think, everything. There's one last thing that I wanted to say, which I was excited about. Okay, because I really enjoyed playing with friends. And
they're not your friends, Dave. They were just people you met.
Yeah, but I make friends easily, okay, Nath. You wouldn't understand. Something that's coming to Ghost Recon Breakpoint is raids. There's going to be raids.
Oh.
And I think that's going to be loads of fun. Like, because already just playing the game is very fun with your team, yeah, but having a very specific kind of difficult objective to work together on and
sure,
figure out.
Sure, it's a completely different experience. So like having, obviously, I've done, the only shooter raids I've done have been in Destiny. And they were, do you remember when that came out? It was like, I know that you didn't get a chance to do that, I think. But,
no, I didn't.
But it takes the kind of shooter dynamic and it puts this incredible emphasis on teamwork and it just makes it a completely different thing. So I agree with you.
Exactly.
That's very exciting.
I'm super jealous that I never did any Destiny raids, but now I'm hoping we could do Ghost Recon Breakpoint raids.
Yeah, okay.
I'm genuinely like really excited about it.
Cool.
So that's everything I learned from playing Ghost Recon Breakpoint. Please like this video if you liked it, and make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell.
Do that.
Please hit the bell so you stay up to date with everything from the world of PlayStation.
For the players.